remove the small circlip from the small hub and remove the hub from the clutch assembly. With the small hub removed, remove the large circlip from the input shaft. Place the puller tool into the bell housing and hook the clips under the casting. Once seated evenly, use a ratchet to press the clutch off the input shaft and carefully lift the clutch assembly from the bell housing. Carefully remove the actuator assembly from the transmission by undoing all of the mounting bolts. You can now remove both the small, then the large release bearing from the bell housing. Now the six cap screws holding the guide tube and fork pivot shaft can be removed, and the forks and guide tube can then be removed all as one. At this point, check the condition of the input shaft seal for any seeping or leakage. Thoroughly degrease and clean the bell housing of any old clutch dust and oil that could contaminate the new clutch. If required, remove the old input shaft seal using a seal puller and carefully install a new one. Mount the actuator assembly on the actuator adjustment jig over the mounting pins. Adjust the actuator stop close to the required 71.5 to 72.5mm length from the reference face on the actuator. Double check this measurement with a vernier caliper from the actuator face. Using the handles, pull the actuators out until they stop and check their length in reference to the actuator stop. If the old clutch has been heavily used, then the actuators will be too short. To adjust the actuators, remove the rubber boot on each actuator. Press the actuator in until you can see the adjusting hole open up in the window. Insert the adjusting tool and ensure it is sitting square in the actuator. Rotate the tool in the actuator to adjust the length. Rotate anti-clockwise to extend or clockwise to shorten. Be careful not to adjust too far or the adjusting nut will fall off in the actuator. Reinstall the rubber plugs into the actuator and remove the actuator from the jig. The new clutch forks and guide tubes can be installed together, taking note of the dowel positions on the pivot shaft. Install the six cap screw bolts using thread retaining compound and torque to 6 Newton meters. Use a high temperature bearing grease to lubricate the fork contact points on the large release bearing. Install this on the large fork. Note, this only fits in one orientation. Use high temperature bearing grease to lubricate the fork contact points on the small release bearing and install in the transmission. Note, this can fit in two different orientations. Both will work fine. Using a small brush, evenly apply high temperature bearing grease to both spines on the input shafts and the bearing press surface. Also apply a small amount of grease to the forks where the actuators pivot. Flip the transmission flat again and carefully remount the actuators. Torque the main mounting bolts to 20 Nm. With the bell housing facing upward again, carefully lift the new clutch assembly into the transmission using the pulling tool. Check that the large spline is engaged on the large input shaft by measuring from the bearing down to the input shaft with a vernier caliper. If the clutch is seated correctly, this should not measure more than 8 mm. Insert the pressing mandrel onto the clutch bearing followed by the pressing jig. Use 3 bolts to mount the pressing jig to the bell housing surface. Use a torque wrench to press the clutch onto the input shaft. Do not exceed 16 Nm whilst pressing the clutch in. Finally, remove the pressing jig from the bell housing. Using circlip pliers and a flathead screwdriver, install the new circlip on the large input shaft. Install the new spline hub and align the damper to it. Press down on the hub against the wave washers and use circlip pliers to install the circlip.